Good morning, everybody. Welcome to a very desert dog Thanksgiving. And you're just in time for the morning flag raising. Try not to flip off the side of the trailer here. We got here last night. It was a little bit late, but it's not officially a campsite until we put up Old Glory. And there we go. Little panorama for you. There she is. Thanksgiving morning. Can't beat it. Little desert action. Probably not too much riding today. Gotta go down and get a couple of supplies we forgot. Maybe I'll take you along for that. And then prepare for turkey ingestion and turkey coma. So we'll have you along for as much as we can of that. Well, here we go. We're packing up to head to convenience store to purchase the aforementioned forgotten, didn't know we needed items. And hopefully get back here in one piece. Need to go find Mrs. Desert Dog. Let her know we're on our way out. They're out hunting lizards. It's a favorite pastime of our yellow lab. They turn over every rock, stick, and bush in the 2 mile radius. They just regraded this road a couple of days ago, it looks like. There was a big old big old hole in the road that's now gone, which is a good thing. And you're bringing an 11,000 pound trailer over it. So we've run 11 miles, 10 miles back to the nearest convenience store, which is an awesome thing. Oops, stupid horn. That looks like one cold dog. Two cold dogs. Alrighty, let's see how successful we're gonna be. Busy, busy place. Bunches of diesel stuff. Let's see. Not too much car stuff. I'm looking for gas treatment and carburetor cleaner. No success. Excuse me, do you guys have sliced meat?
Sliced meat?
Yeah, like ham, sliced ham.
You're gonna have to get your lady right there.
Okay. Excuse me, ma'am. Do you have sliced ham? Sliced ham?
Ham?
Ham. Meat? Sliced meat? Ham?
Ham?
Yeah.
Which one?
I just need like a half a pound of sliced ham.
Let me call that in.
Okay.
Hi.
Good morning. How are you? I'm looking for like a half a pound of sliced ham.
Would you?
This conversation has gone full circle. They sent me the kitchen lady. Kitchen lady went back to the. Okay, thank you. I appreciate it. Have a good Thanksgiving. Well, that was comical. Let's move on to the next place. See if they've got any. You never know. Look at this poor guy. He's driving a wrecked car and pulling a wrecked car. That guy must have had a really bad day. Out of fuel, need a few bucks. Stop here. See what kind of magic we can find here. One down. No carb cleaner. So, we got bologna beef, bologna and salami. No ham. Oh well. A ham and a sandwich. Hello. You guys don't sell sliced ham, do you?
No.
No?
536.
Thank you. Well, there is a town a few miles from here we can go check out. See if that'll work. Hey, buddy. Happy Thanksgiving. Well, we didn't make it to the next town. I didn't fill up before I left, not thinking I'd have to go that far. And it got to be too late, and the empty light's blinking at me. So you never know if in these little towns anything's gonna be open, so I could have got there empty, and gas stations closed until tomorrow, which would have really sucked on Thanksgiving. So we'll head back. We've got our gas treatment, see if that helps for the generator. And if we need to, we'll run over to Bouse later tomorrow when we know the stores will be open and get our ham and carb cleaner. Woohoo! Time to tie the feed bag on. Turkey is an hour away. All right, well, it's time to fire up ye old oven. Let's see how this works out. There we go. Try not to blow ourselves up here. Takes a while to purge. There we go. We've got light off. There we go. Let her heat up and we'll have turkey in no time.
Can you say happy Thanksgiving, YouTubers? Mrs. Desert Dog. Prepare for the turkey coma. It comes pre-cut. We got the fine china here. Got our turkey napkins. I'm gonna say grace and chow down, so we'll see you later. Well, if you're gonna eat here, you've gotta worry about someone watching you the whole time, because she wants her fair share. It's time for to enact the turkey coma. It's been long enough after dinner. We've done and done our after dinner constitutional, walked around the campsite, and time for a...
He's going to learn you how to build a Desert Dog white man fire. First, you need a average soda can. Pop the top off about 2/3 of the way up. Hopefully it won't fight you like that. You use your favorite flavor. You can use diesel, but you'll need a wick. I got diesel over there. I'm using gasoline, and that's easier to start. So we're going to... This can is awfully full, so need to be careful. Don't need very much, about halfway up. Our wood's already over by the fire ring. Had to make a redneck truck repair earlier. One of the cables to the tailgate broke loose. We used a little duct tape up in there. Working perfect now. Permanent fix. So take your little can of gasoline. Pop right down in the center. Pile your wood over top. You don't want too much because we ain't going to hang outside too long. And I forgot a lighter. Hang on. So we got ourselves a little portable flame here, and we will light her up. Now we'll come back in a couple minutes, and we should have pretty rocking fire going. Well, it's not officially a white man fire yet, but within a few minutes we've got a pretty good fire going, and she'll be up and running here pretty quick. But we've got ourselves official campfire in 3.5 seconds flat. So commencement of Thanksgiving Day festivities. We're gonna put the flag away. And most people don't know, some people don't know, that you're not supposed to fly the flag at night or in bad weather. There's a couple things you can do. You can either take her down, fold her up, don't let the flag touch the ground. Two, you can shine a light on her. You can cover her up, or you can wrap her up, and that's what I'm going to do. Done. So I keep using the noggin cam because it's windy this time of year, so we using the smaller cam microphone just picks up all the wind. So no one else around to laugh at me wearing my helmet all over the place, except for Mrs. Desert Dog. She thinks I'm completely insane anyway. I'm gonna go over and check on the puppy who's out lizard hunting. Hello? Did she get any yet? So, I know it looks like I'm sitting in a big paved parking lot, but that's not the case. What you see is, it's rock. I think it was suspended in sand, and it became this layer all over the place. It's about an inch thick, or a few rocks thick, all the way across. And what's happened is, the rocks have gotten what's called desert varnish on them. So the top part, what you see on the top, the sun has, I wouldn't call it damaged it, but they call it desert varnish, turns it black. And the other side is this really neat red color, orange color. I don't know if the camera picks up, that's not really a good example. Most of them are really bright orange on the bottom. Like that one there. But makes a good camping surface. Nobody gets dirty. Except for the dog. Here's one that's, whoa, really black on the top. And really orange on the bottom. Thank you, Father, for all the freedoms we enjoy. Thank you for putting us in this great land. We pray for your protection and restoration of our freedoms. Thank you for our families. Thank you for the right to worship. Thank you for ability to work, material things that we have. We thank you for your mercy. Amen.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when.